How do you do, kind folks?
Hello!
Slam and Skits back together again. Hey! Today we're going to be doing a semi-podcast, if you will. A podcast, a cast light, if you will. You guys have seen me do some tier lists on the channel, but you haven't seen me and Skits do a tier list, and I thought
that was true.
What's a better tier list than a Mario tier list? That's right, ladies and gentlemen. We're reviewing what?
I will have an honorary mention at the end that's not on there
quite. We will be reviewing all the mainline Mario games. The ones that there may be some that you aren't aware of. There may be some that you probably think we're forgetting, like,
Donkey Kong.
Yes.
For example.
I would clarify, and the reason for that is that even though Mario is in it, technically...
He ain't Mario yet,
and he's... Jumpman. I would consider that a Donkey Kong game, if you will.
It's kind of both.
Yes, so if you were to play... If we were to rank all the Donkey Kong games, that game would be in it. But since we're not,
I guess that, we ain't. Yeah, that one kind of goes either way. But.
Indeed. And you won't be seeing stuff like Luigi's Mansion or anything like that, because that's not a Mario game.
Since you say that, I guess, based on what I see in front of us, a little rule of the tier list here is it has to have Luigi in it as well. I take that back. There is one or two that doesn't.
Yeah. It's gotta have...
Never mind.
Here's the thing, okay? This has to have... Here's the rules for this, okay? No Smash Bros, okay? That's a whole other list. No Mario Kart, that's a whole other list.
Yep.
No Mario Sports, that's, a whole other list.
Yep.
It's gotta be a platformer. It's gotta have... Mario as the main character and not Jumpman, not anything else, okay?
Yeah.
It's gotta have Mario in it, and it's gotta be from Nintendo, so it can't be like, I don't know, Super Communist Brothers or whatever.
Super Communist Brothers.
There's some kind of weird... Oh, God. There's some kind of weird bootleg game that's like Mario Bros, but not that, you know, whatever. Anyway.
Oh, okay.
And it's gotta be, you know, Mario's gotta be in it. And even if he's got a small cameo, that doesn't count, okay? No, that doesn't count. It's like Super Luigi U or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Even though it may maybe have Mario in it, tiny bit, maybe.
Yep.
That doesn't count. No.
Nope.
It's a DLC. Doesn't matter. Anyway, though, I think I came up with a pretty comprehensive list here.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Indubitably. So
I'm good with it.
Let's begin this list with...
I'm gonna nitpick.
What?
I'm not gonna nitpick. It's pretty solid.
Indeed.
The majority of them are there. What do we start with?
All of them are there. Anyway. The newest one, Super Mario Bros. Wonder. This one, I know you haven't played.
Oh, good. That makes that better.
Yeah, it's the newest one.
How can I rank that?
It's the newest one.
It is.
Pretty, apparently it's getting really rave reviews.
I've heard good things.
I've heard good things as well.
I might buy it today. Who knows?
Hey, who knows?
Because I forgot about it, and I meant to get it.
Hey, if I got money, I would purchase it, but I don't, so I won't. Anyway. Anyway, though, yeah. So, haven't played it. This is probably going to be the only one that will be here because it's so new. We both haven't played it.
There might be more. We'll see.
And
let's find out.
Super Mario Run. This is the...
I have not played that in a while.
This is a mobile game, one of the Nintendo's only mobile games.
Yeah.
That I don't even think is you can play it anymore on the phone anymore.
I don't know.
Like sometimes I guess sometimes, you know, once it gets old, you can't play it anymore. But yeah,
that's
anyway.
How it goes sometimes. Yeah,
that's what happens with the the Mario Kart app, they had the DLC or whatever on the new Mario Kart game that's like an expansion pack.
Oh, the smartphone Mario Kart?
Yeah. They moved all those things over to the Mario Kart 8 or whatever. But anyway.
Well, okay.
Because I guess they stopped.
I didn't know that ended.
Yeah, I don't know.
I totally missed that.
I don't know.
Oh, well. Whatever.
Anyway, Super Mario Run. This is a fairly decent game, I would say. It's not the best, but it's certainly not the worst, as we'll come to see. It's fairly high up there. It gets the job done. If you want to go travel around, yep, you know, playing a Mario game, regular Mario game, this is going to... is gonna get your craving down, but it's just, that's kind of it. It doesn't expand anything, it doesn't do anything, it's just there, you know. I just feel like it's there.
Yep, it's for waiting in line at the theme park,
basically.
It's one of those
waiting in line at the Nintendo Land theme park.
Oh yeah,
with your,
yeah, there you go,
with Mario. Okay, Mario will play Super, yep, Mario Run with you on your phone.
Yeah.
And then steal it. Oh, rusted. Anyway.
Oh, no.
Would put it in C tier. What would you say?
I mean, compared to what else is on the list, that's tough. I didn't even realize that's what that was.
Super Mario Run?
Yeah, I thought that's something different.
It's probably on here somewhere else.
Yeah, we'll put it on a... Yeah, I'll match you on C tier.
Indeed.
I haven't played it much, but I remember it being surprisingly well made.
Indeed. Also, here's a tricky part too.
Yeah.
Say, I say a game's an S tier, you say it's a B tier, okay? It's going to be A tier.
Yeah, that makes sense.
It's the compromise.
Yep, we're finding the mean value.
Indeed. Super new Super Mario Bros.
U on the Wii U. Yep.
I have not played it because I'm too cool for a Wii U. Really? You haven't played this?
No.
Even though you have a Wii U?
Nope.
Wow.
I don't have any Wii U games, actually.
What the heck? You call yourself a gamer.
You know why I have that?
Why?
So I can play Wii games and have them look good on a modern TV with HDMI. It actually is really great, even just for that purpose.
Hey, have you seen Scott the Waz's new...
Hey all, Scott here.
Yeah, Wii U.
No.
Birth of a Downfall, Downfall of a Downfall series or whatever. Those are
pretty funny.
He goes over the entirety of the Wii U's life.
Yeah,
it's pretty funny.
It was great, but they didn't market it too well. That was their problem.
Indeed. So I guess we'll put it in the haven't played section, which is surprising. But yeah, what would you say? Is the Wii U a actual console or is it an add-on?
No, it's definitely a console.
Okay.
The graphics are actually better than the Wii. Like, it's...
Some people qualify the Wii U as like an add-on.
Yeah, it's kind of its own thing.
It's kind of in that gray area. I would see people saying, yeah, the Wii U is its own console. But I would also see people saying, yeah, it's an add-on because it's...
Yeah. I've heard that also, but I can tell you the graphics are definitely better.
It's like the Kinect. The Kinect is not, you know...
That is an add-on.
That's an add-on, but there are games specifically made for that.
For the same console, though.
Indeed.
Yeah. I gotcha.
It's a gray area, I don't know. Anyway.
What's next?
Super Mario 64. Ladies and gentlemen...
Automatic
pinnacle
S tier.
Why though?
It's
Mario. Listen, this game, okay, revolutionized.
It did.
The purity, the 3D-ness of Mario. Okay,
it did.
Listen, it totally redefined it. What's your favorite part of Super Mario 64, son?
It's one of those that has a very high replay value, actually. I have beaten the entire game, both in the sense of saving Peach from Bowser and in collecting all 120 stars, where you get to see polygon-tastic Yoshi on the roof of the castle.
Duh. I missed all MLG for like 128 stars.
120 stars for me.
Anyway, though, it's a certified banger, okay? And apparently, it's got a few bugs.
A few, yes. And a lot. That's part of why it's awesome.
It's fairly buggy, okay?
Yeah. A lot of glitches.
But then again, this is the first N64 game. One of the first N64 games. Yep. So they were ironing out the kinks.
Yeah.
Do we factor that into this ranking, though?
The game is just that good. For me, I've played it so many times.
Here's the thing. I love it. Because it's buggy, I would put it personally in A tier, but I will concede to a low S tier.
Aw, thanks.
But yeah, it's simply just remarkable, okay? The stuff that they do completely revolutionized Mario in all of its forms.
Oh, yeah.
Okay?
And fun fact, that is not the first game that Mario talked in with Charles Martinet.
Who? Apparently. No, he did. He retired. And actually, Super Mario Bros. Wonder is the first game without Charles Martinet.
I'm buying that today, then I gotta witness it.
Yeah, we all have to witness.
Oh, no. It's not gonna be the same.
No, it's not.
Oh, that hurts. I did not know he retired.
He did. It's all over the news. Yeah, Super Mario Bros. Wonder. He did not return for Super Mario Bros. Wonder. It's the first game where he's not the Mario.
He is Mario.
I mean, Chris Pratt's Mario now.
Roasted. I guess, yeah. Get Mark Gru or Grawl back in here and be like,
baby, I want to touch your garlic bread.
This is a kind of truck up, you know, but I like it.
Okay, so. Super Mario Bros. 2.
In Japan, known as.
And not Super Mario Bros. 2.
Not the one you're thinking of. It is called. And this is how it is said in the commercial. Super Mario USA!
Oh, okay. So there's that.
And it's on a pink cartridge.
Quite. Apparently this was... Is this the game that was, another game? Yeah, probably that. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, and they just pasted Mario into it?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
It worked well, though.
I suppose so. I played it.
I played it many times.
Yeah, it's fairly hard for me, and I don't know. I don't like it that much.
Not your thing? It's a little different.
It just reeks of laziness to me. I guess if you know the backstory and all that, it just reeks of laziness, you know? I don't know.
See what you're getting at.
Yeah. Yeah.
They did improve the gameplay a tad bit. Actually.
I suppose.
Like, you can actually sprint. Because in the original one on the Famicom disc system, you're walking or just jogging. You're not. If you hold down the B button.
Sorry, we're in North America, okay? The NES is where we're at, okay?
Yes.
No, Famicom.
NES.
No, Famicom, okay? And NES. We got NES, okay? NES.
NES. And the dog is asleep. Holy crap.
Indeed, kind folks. The Sackbuster is, in fact, sleeping.
And you know what else, kind folks? If you look at the box there, see, Mario has red overalls and a blue shirt.
He doesn't have that.
In the game, No, he. That's not what I'm getting at. In the actual game, he has blue overalls and a red shirt.
Once again,
I always thought that was funny. It's a good, it's a cool, iconic box art, though.
I guess.
I can't hate it. I'm sorry.
It's just, lazy. It's listen, iconic. You gotta put the right colors in there. Yeah, kind of, folks. Yeah, it's a Mario enough. Game. It's your core essential game.
Yeah.
Sequel to your core essential game. You gotta get that color
and
together.
We'll get to that here in a moment, I have a feeling. But based on what's coming up next. But, no, that one is all day an A tier for me.
A tier?
Not quite an S tier, but it's an A tier.
Wow, okay.
A lot of the enemies in that game were, like, iconic bad guys in later games. You know, King Bob-omb?
Yeah,
the Bob-ombs came out in that game. Shy Guys?
I was gonna put it in B tier, but... Because you put the bomb-bombs in there.
Bomb-bombs.
Just barely squeak out in A-. It is a literally 89.9%, okay? You literally have an 89.9%. That will technically get you an A. If you grade on a script.
If any of you have a Game Boy Advance, definitely check out the...
A GBA.
Yes. Go ahead and try a Super Mario Advance, which is a great recreation of this based on the Super Nintendo Super Mario All-Stars version of this game. And let me tell you, I love that version equally as much on the GBA. It's because now we have characters talking, and when you get to Bowser, one of the bosses, it's this giant mouse with sunglasses. He's just like, here, have some bombs.
Here, have some cheese.
Have some bombs. And then if you hit him, like, you have to throw the bombs back at him 3 times. And if he gets hit, he's like, I don't know why.
Anyway, though, Super Mario Bros. Oh, the Lost Levels.
I love that game. Anyway, I love that one too. I don't hate any of these, to be honest.
This is harder. Attest, this is harder than Mario Bros, I guess. This is the...
Yeah.
What is this? These are the scraps from the first game, or what?
No, not necessarily. It's honestly just a really more true, direct sequel to the first game.
Yeah,
it's like a, you know.
That's why I put it on here, because it's technically the real Mario, Super Mario 2,
which I do have.
But
I thought we were not in North. I thought we were North America.
This is in North America.
guess what? I got it shipped overseas, bro.
No!
Mom, get the camera. eBay, let's go.
MLG Pro. Anyway,
yeah, you have to be that for this game.
Yeah, because it's hard.
Let me tell you something.
It's a hard one. Okay.
I've beaten the first game in the original NES era ones. I've beaten one. I've beaten two that we just gave an A ranking. I've beaten three, which we'll get to later.
Yeah, not beaten.
I've
this
never
one.
Been able to beat this one.
This one's hard for
it,
me.
Like, I even using warp zones, I can't.
Yeah, it's
awful.
Yeah,
I've gotten to like world 5 or 4, I think, and that's it. There's this one level where there's this stupid jump that you have to time so perfectly.
Yeah, this is
God.
The thing is, like with Mario Bros, Super Mario Bros, they perfected that gameplay.
Here,
they were testing some things, and they went a little They went a little overboard with certain things, okay? You gotta be very MLG pro for this, okay? Listen.
That's why they were a little hesitant to release it anywhere else, because it was so difficult.
It's too hard. Not even the Japanese can do it, okay?
I guess. So some people have. If I tried it enough, I probably would beat it, but I just have to get back to it. But, nonetheless, I'd give it an A.
No, I'd... give it a C, because it's so difficult.
That means it's B for Boomish the Bear.
B for Boomish. Anyway, yeah. The original arcade Mario Bros.
Living in my garage. There it is.
Indeed.
Great port on the NES as well.
Quite. So, son, what you got to say about this game here?
That one gets overlooked sometimes. I do think in more recent years, Nintendo has made better efforts to, you know, show appreciation for it. So, this is the first game where Luigi made his appearance. This is also the first game where the Koopas appear. Although they are known as Shell Creepers.
AKA making the bros in Mario Bros.
Making them bros! You know?
Also, apparently, wasn't this one the one where, cracking open that C4 of your kind of getting the game.
Z4, yeah.
Isn't this the first one where they're plumbers too?
That is true. Yep, you are correct.
Isn't Donkey Kong, he's a carpenter.
And Junior. Donkey Kong Junior as well. Yeah,
because, you know, barrels, wood, carpentry, it kind of works.
Girders.
And, you know, Mario Bros., there's pipes. Works better if he's a plumber, you know?
Yep.
But then the plumber thing stuck, I guess, you know?
Yep, they just stuck, they ran with it. I love that game so much. You're not going to see me part with mine ever.
What, Mario Bros.?
Yeah, that one is one of the most expensive machines I ever acquired.
Quite.
For sure. Definitely top three. For arcade games, not pinball included, but...
How's the gameplay, though, son?
Great.
Great?
I mean, 8 out of 8? Yes, I'm very sure about it.
Are you absolutely sure about that? I mean, are there no flaws or anything about that?
The only flaw I can think of is maybe... And to their credit, you know, they hadn't refined it yet. The jumping mechanics are a little awkward and take getting used to if you haven't played it before, but that's about it.
Yeah, I kind of have to agree there on that kind of thing.
The POW block came from this game.
Plates.
Shell creeper crabs. nope, those are the... Oh my god, I'm sorry. Sidestep, I think is what those are called. And the fighter flies that jump, slip ice, the icicle thing that freezes the platforms. What I can tell you for sure is the arcade version is a hell of a lot harder than the NES port. Yeah.
Indeed. So where would you rank it, son?
Give it an S.
Oh.
Only be,
wow.
But that's partially a biased S.
But I would.
I can't not praise that one. It's
I was gonna give it an A.
Okay.
So, what would you consider putting it into an A tier?
Yeah, that's fair.
Okay.
That's fair.
Yeah, because. Personally, for me, they completely ironed out everything with the Super Mario Bros. On the NES.
Correct.
It's just a little bit too rough to put an S tier for me personally, but
yeah,
I don't know. Anyway,
I could play that game over and over again.
Super Mario Maker 2.
I have not played that one, so that's a great one, I guess.
No.
Oh, you played it?
Yes.
All right, I'll let you rank it then.
So I played this on the DS.
Wait, I thought that was the first one that was on the DS.
Let me see here. Which one was the DS? I remember...
I'm pretty sure the original one was... Actually, I think it was the 3DS that it came out on.
Let's see here. What... When I say DS, I mean 3DS or DS, whatever. It's
different consoles.
Whatever. Anyway.
Different.
Super Mario
Maker.
Maker 2. Not an online game.
The Switch. And nothing but the Switch.
What the heck? What is it?
Okay, well, I guess...
You probably played the first one, though.
I did play the first one. And I played the second one, too. I remember... Okay. I can't remember, but anyway.
Huh.
I remember... They're both basically the same thing.
Yeah, I figured it was. Except...
This one, I thought that... They made a big... It was either... It was one of them. I can't remember which one, but there was one of them that... they made such a big, huge deal about sharing your levels, but there was no way to share your levels with anybody.
I guess that's I know you could definitely do that in the first one. And I remember you people would share them and you'd play some of these levels that were ridiculously hard.
Yeah.
You just couldn't get through it.
I mean, eventually, you could... Yeah. Eventually you could, but I there was one that was like, it took a while for it to actually come to console or whatever.
I don't know.
Share them online. Choose new features and course assets, including a single player story mode. Okay. I can't...
Story
levels
mode?
Based on 3D world. New level assets based on 3D world. Okay.
Yeah, that's cool.
They kind of blend together, honestly. I one of them...
Yeah.
I think this is the one that kind of was right out of the box you can play online.
Yeah, could have been.
The first one took a while.
Maybe that's what it was.
I'll put the first one in F tier, honestly.
What?
But anyway, second one...
Fair enough.
Second one, I put it... I'll put it in high B tier.
That's where I would put the first one.
Okay. Well, we'll get to that when we get to that. Anyway.
I thought we were... Okay. I thought we were blending them together since they're that similar. But okay.
No, because there's one thing that's different. We'll get to it when we get to
it. Well, you already know my ranking for it then.
Anyway, though.
Oh, well. What's
in between this... these two games, just like what is it The Sting was the best picture winner in between The Godfather and Godfather Part 2. I know, film reference. Super Mario Odyssey,
Smoke,
ladies and gentlemen,
the big Smoke.
I know you haven't played it, but
you know I haven't played it.
Yeah, you haven't played it.
You know that for a fact.
Yeah, I know, because you helped me and you did. You haven't... I know you haven't played it.
Oh, I've definitely played it.
Oh, you have? Oh, okay.
I've got almost all of the moves.
I stand corrected. This...
Wow!
This game... Wow. This game...
The bee's knees. It was like a... In a way, it did a lot of the good things that 64 did.
Let me say this, okay?
Yeah.
As much as you're hyped for what is your most hyped Mario game? Like Mario Bros. On the arcade or whatever?
For hype alone being bigger than...
I don't know, the NES, whatever. This is my favorite Mario game.
Oh, okay. I see what you're saying.
Off the cuff.
It's not Mario Bros., but yeah.
This is my favorite Mario game, okay? Listen.
Yeah.
Okay. The worlds that you go and see and do, wonderful. Okay? It is beautiful.
It was very well done.
It is very
well
done.
It's still very well done.
Listen. The fact they made Mario's hat a living, breathing creature...
That was very, very clever.
On paper, it sounds absolutely stupid. But in, you know, actual... usage, it worked. Okay?
Yeah.
Amazing. It reminds me of Majora's Mask a little bit, where Link kind of...
yeah.
Link kind of puts the mask on and becomes creatures.
Yeah.
Mario swings the hat and becomes those creatures too. It's kind of creative.
And
okay?
The moon plays a big role in both games. Wow! Wow!
Mm-hmm.
Wow!
Mm-hmm. So anyway.
But anyway.
I also love... I mean, there's a few... There's two spots in this game that I can remember that were absolutely just atrociously hard that I couldn't get through, and I need you to get through.
Even, you know, yeah, some of them were more difficult than others, for sure, but none of them were just bad. They just were hard.
Yeah. One was the final battle, and one was, I think it was in the desert or something.
Oh, the one on the boot? The actual boot?
Maybe, I don't know, but there was... I know there was one.
Yeah.
It was the ending one with Bowser. That was the hard. That was really hard. And then there was the one in the desert, I think.
But in the desert?
There
really?
Was, there, oh. was, there was something... I know there was two spots that I needed your help with, but I can't remember what they were. But anyway.
I think it was the...
I know one was the last one.
The purple vomiting rabbit guy.
Yeah, that one. I thought it was in the desert.
New characters, by the way. The evil rabbit family. I don't know what that's supposed to mean.
Hey, okay.
Yeah.
If we got walking, talking bombs, okay? Shrooms. Walking, talking shrooms, okay?
Okay.
We can have bunnies, okay? Throwing up bunnies, okay? Listen.
Here I go!
Anyway, though, I think the ending joke also...
That was funny. She was like, just left them both.
Chef's kiss. Peach left both of them. Chef's kiss. Beautiful.
That's fine.
And yeah, honestly, this animation style, I dare say, it's better than the movie, the Super Mario Bros. Movie from Illumination Animation. Yeah, this animation's better.
You know what? This is being computer generated in real time. It's not like a high dollar, you know, graphics workstation
kind of
having to do it and then you record the footage.
Kind of a slight on Illumination Animation.
Yeah,
take a
look at Switch version.
I will fight to the death to give this game an S tier. It has to be an S tier. I'm sorry.
And it is also for me.
Is it above Super Mario 64 though?
It's equal.
It's buggy. It was buggy. I said it was
A little bit. Not like 64.
Bottom of S tier. But yeah.
64 is more like there. It has these glitches that you wouldn't necessarily encounter unless you know about them. And then seek them out, which is hilarious. Jumping on top of the castle by backwards jumping up the side of the hill.
Oh, also, I forgot to mention too.
Yeah.
There is so much love for Mario in this game. It's like a celebration of everything Mario, okay?
Yeah.
We have the NES side-scrollers in like a side game
quest,
okay?
Donkey Kong. Oh, yeah, you go in the pipes and it makes it an 8-bit 2D Mario.
Yes.
And then Donkey Kong also.
Yes.
That's fun.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Pauline comes back.
Ladies and gentlemen, mic drop right here, okay? Listen, there you go. Anyway.
Kaboom.
Super Mario Maker, my gosh.
Okay.
No.
Yes?
No. It is...
Toilet.
So, if that was it, I would give it a B tier, okay? But, the fact that they, you know, teased the whole, like, playing, like, sharing your levels online, and it took them forever to do that.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, no. No. Red X. So,
yeah.
If that was the... Because of that, I would give it F tier, okay? But, you still give it B tier, so we gotta put it in the middle. I don't know, probably...
Let's see.
It's between C and D, I guess.
D+, I guess?
D+. Because technically it's a good game, but with that crap Nintendo pulled, no, I'm sorry, no. Red X.
So what, C tier maybe?
Nah, I'm putting D+ tier.
Okay.
Right there.
Very well.
Just because of that. But
okay.
Super Mario Maker 2, decent enough. But yeah, Nintendo, don't do that to your fans. I'm sorry. Anyway.
I did not know they did that. Oh.
Okay. I know they did it with one of them. I can't remember which one it was, but they did it with one of them. So we're just going to put the first one there, I guess.
I see.
For the fans, if you will. Anyway.
Oh, gosh.
Super Mario 3D World.
On the 3DS.
Indeed.
Pretty good.
Have you played it?
I have.
Okay, good, because I haven't.
It's pretty good.
What can you tell us about it, son?
The idea is it's more of like a...
Like the 2D side-scroller type of deal?
It plays more like, you know, one of the old Mario games.
The side-scroller.
Yeah. Where it's linear with levels.
Yeah.
But the levels are in 3D, but it's not an open-world thing.
Yeah.
That's the idea. It was pretty... I remember it being pretty good. I'd say it's an easy A for me.
Easy A?
Yeah.
Can you tell us anything more about it, or what?
It's been a while since I played it. The 3D effect on the 3DS is pretty neat.
Any new characters or anything, or...?
There could have been, but I don't know if I've played enough of it to see that. I could be wrong. Who knows? But I liked what I played of it. It was pretty good. I'll have to revisit it one day.
Alright. I guess I'll put it in between Mario Bros. And Super Mario Bros. 2 right there. How about that?
Very.
Super Mario 3D Land. I haven't played this either.
Is that on the Switch or the Wii U?
I thought it was, since it's 3D Land, I thought it was on the 3DS as well. Let's double check. Super Mario 3D
Land.
It's for the 3DS.
Wait. Oh, I'm so sorry. I got them backwards.
That's Super Mario 3D World is on the 3DS as well, and the Wii U.
Wii U.
It is on the Wii U. 3D World is on the Wii U.
Okay, that's what it
is. The sequel to the 3D Land on the DS.
Okay, so swap them around, I guess.
Switch them. We're gonna put this back over here, kind folks, and put this over here.
Yep, got the names backwards.
Indeed. 3D World.
That one I have not played.
So before anything happens here, swap out the land. Swap out world with land. And now, actual 3D World. Here we go.
Exactly.
You haven't played it, so...
I have not.
Well,
it looked good, though.
It seemed decent enough. I can't tell you, because I don't have a Wii U. And this is a Wii U game, so... What? Yeah, it's all...
Hi, folks.
My
I'm sorry.
My sugar's a tad high, but not that high. Not that
what?
High.
A little concerned there.
Yeah. Super Mario Galaxy 2. My gosh. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me right now?
I'm not kidding you, kind folks. I know a lot more about 1 than 2, but I have played both.
I know more about 1 than 2 as well, but kind folks. Kindly.
Yeah, kind folks.
It's a miracle, okay? It's a miracle you have this game to begin with. Okay?
I don't own it, actually.
That you... call yourself a gamer.
I rented it from Blockbuster.
What the
talk
heck
about
is
a
wrong
throwback.
With you. You need to
that
purchase
hey,
that thing.
So. That is how old the Wii is at this point.
I mean, yeah, but
oh my god, that's crazy.
Yeah, so
Blockbuster died before the Wii ended, I think.
Yeah.
Wow.
Anyway, though.
Man.
Super Mario Galaxy 2.
It's pretty good.
Fairly much the same thing as Super Mario Galaxy, but they add a little bit more. They iron out They iron out a little bit more of the bugs from the previous game, I would say. They,
interesting.
If I remember it correctly.
The first one wasn't terribly buggy. I know there were a few.
It wasn't terribly buggy, but then they I guess they ironed out the animation and all that, made it a little bit more pop, made it pop a little
I
bit more.
I thought the first one popped pretty well.
It did.
Mean, from what I remember. It,
Super Mario Galaxy 2 popped a little up tad.
It probably did.
There was
software.
There was one thing. There was one thing that I remember that people kind of had a nitpick on it, but other than that, it was pretty well done, I would say. Can you think of anything wrong with that that gamers might detest about that? Because I can't remember.
I don't know. I remember Yoshi appeared. Well, obviously, you see that on the cover there. Yoshi's voice was a little annoying in this one for some reason. I don't think that's what you're thinking of.
I don't think so either. But
that was my nitpick of it mainly. That, and I think there was a lot of like going back and kind of like Mario Odyssey, which there was a lot of going between 2D and 3D parts. I remember there was a lot more of that than in the first one.
Okay.
I don't know if that's it either. That's
maybe
just an observation.
Maybe it was. Maybe that was it. Because, you know, 2D Mario is kind of hard to deal with like, the Wii remote. Maybe.
Not as much as you think.
Not as much, but maybe, I don't know. Some
if you flip the remote sideways.
Yeah, I know.
It's but like an NES controller. Gosh, golly, gee.
Indeed. But anyway, I feel comfortable giving it a A+. How about you?
Yeah, I was gonna say that one's probably an A.
Yeah.
Barely an A. Nah. We'll give it an A. I'd have to revisit it for a more.
So in between 95 and 100. So 97, still an A+, whatever. Anyway. Roasted. Anyway.
Roasted.
What is
Super Mario Land 2?
Is that what that?
That's exactly what that is.
Okay, I haven't played it. When you?
I have.
Okay, well then.
Guys, I own this game complete in the box for the original Game Boy.
Guys, I'm so MLG pro. Why am I still a virgin, guys?
It's not like my shaft is thin. No, I'm kidding. But
roasted.
Well, actually,
commentary on that. But anyway,
ladies, it's good. That's all we'll say.
Ladies, get on this. Stop. No, triple X. No, we're not triple X here. Anyway.
420XXX. Anyway,
Scott the Waz, everybody. Anyway.
Yeah.
Super Mario Land 2.
Very good game.
Is it? What's
the worst part of it is that
what goes on in this game? What draws you to
it's
it?
It's a really well developed
Is it 2D?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it's on the 8-bit Game Boy.
I don't know. I haven't owned a Game Boy. I don't play it.
To refresh your memory, remember the original Game Boy is like a green
screen. Yeah, I know
dot
that
matrix.
I keep on getting the GBA and the GB mixed up. On my apologies.
I got
you. The predecessor to the DS.
Correct. You know, aside from dealing with playing it on a good luck following its screen on the Game Boy, because it is so blurry. It's so blurry. It's ridiculous. If you plug it into like a Game Boy Color or an Advance, once you're able to actually see it, it's a really good platformer. I mean, it's a very, very good game. I believe there were some. I can't recall if there were. I think there might have been new enemies, but they were mainly like new variations of old enemies, if that makes sense. Like they behave differently, with different characteristics.
Indeed. Can you name any of these enemies?
No.
It's
just like Koopas and Goombas. Like when you stomp on them, maybe they behave differently, something like that.
I see. Anyway, though, where would you rate said game?
That is going to be an A tier.
A tier. A minus or A plus or just A?
Probably just A.
Just A? All right.
If it came out on the Game Boy Color and had, you know, like the actual color graphics, it'd probably be even better.
Personally.
Okay. But
I'm going to put it in between Mario Bros. And Super Mario 3 Land, if you will.
I see.
And now,
oh boy,
Super Mario World.
Oh, father dearest.
Not Super Mario 3D World.
No, I know the difference, mate.
2D
World. I know the difference.
Is this good or bad?
Oh, good.
Oh, is it's it good? Is it good?
It's so good, Karen. That one might even be my favorite of all the first four 2D Mario games.
Oh, whoa. Kind folks.
It is so fun, and it plays so smoothly, and the
this is
mechanics are really fluid. It just...
This is the untitled Super Mario 4, right? Basically.
In America. Japan, it actually is Super Mario Bros. 4. Mario World. It's a subtitle.
Interesting. Okay.
I have both.
Quite, of course.
There are some subtle differences, but they're not noteworthy enough for this video.
I see. I only on the older consoles, I only got up to Super Mario Bros. 3, honestly. But yeah,
it's very similar to 3.
Well, that's good at least. But the controls are just buttery smooth, apparently.
Yeah. I mean, 3 is pretty good too, to be honest. It's they're both like way up there, but World just has that extra little bit that makes it just slightly more fun than 3.
Quite.
To me.
I get you.
So, and that's hard to say a bad thing about 3, but I had to.
Alright. So I'm guessing I assumed it was S tier. Is it above 64?
No, it's, I think, equal.
Oh, equal? Alright, well, I'll
it's,
put it
it's,
right.
It's different.
Slightly buggy. I'll put it right there. How's that?
I'd say it's less buggy.
No, like, 64 is more buggy. So
definitely.
So, is this a good spot, or what?
Absolutely.
Anyway, the last one that I have no idea on because I've not seen anything, Super Mario Land, ladies and gentlemen. One. Son, do you know anything about this game?
I do.
Indeed. Let's hear it.
So, it came out as it may have been a launch title for the Game Boy. I know it was 1989. Daisy was first shown in this game.
AKA the damsel in distress for the Super Mario Bros. The movie, everybody. Okay, listen, the live action film.
Yeah. I forgot about that. Yeah. Yep, you're right. No, Daisy is the D-I-D, the DID of the game. DID, I like that. That's a good acronym.
The DID, yes.
The DID, yes. So I remember it had like this very, Middle Eastern Sahara Desert kind of thing going on. For some reason, it just had that kind of a theme.
Oh, and that explains the desert scene in Super Mario Odyssey. Now I get it.
Sort of, yeah. Yeah, dun, 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 it dun. Might. That might be part of the inspiration for that.
Dun, 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 dun. Anyway.
It's a little bit more akin to the original SNB on the NES. In my opinion. Just harder to see because it's on the Game Boy. I think the second one's a little bit more fun. The second one's definitely more in-depth. This is genuinely, like, it plays almost, not identical, but very, very similar to the first Super Mario Bros. So, you've played that one. This one is definitely in that lineage. Just, you know, again, kind of like the second game. The first one here, Super Mario Land 1, has slightly different enemies. I remember one of the boss battles, you know, I don't think Bowser's over there. Oh yeah, that was another thing. Instead of Bowser, it's like this fire-spitting Egyptian lion thing, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay.
Something like that. Yeah, I haven't played that one in a while, but it's a good game. I'd say that one, it's probably a B+.
B+. I'll put it right there. How's that?
That'll work.
Indeed.
It's just shy of an A.
Super Mario Bros. Are you kidding me right now?
Oh, that's
ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, okay, listen. The game that basically reinvigorated the video game genre, the video game, what?
Crash?
No, reinvigorated the video game...
Market,
yeah.
It did.
Are you kidding me right now? The game that single-handedly saved the video game, saved video games in all of its entirety right now?
Yeah.
Okay, listen. Listen, okay? Amazing. Okay, listen. And it was... I can't believe that this was... A Mario game was a launch title for the NES.
It was very close. I'd say
very close,
remember
yes.
It came out like a month later or something.
I mean,
I don't remember exactly. But,
I know
yeah.
It was... I know this was like packaged into it. It's like the NES or whatever.
The more common... variant you would see in the 80s,
yeah,
especially the later 80s releases with the Super Mario Bros. Duck Hunt.
I cannot believe that it even exists. Okay, it's like,
yeah,
it's like having Wii Sports for the Wii, basically,
yeah,
in my eyes, but yeah, it's listen, ladies and gentlemen, what can we say? It's classic, okay, it's classic for a reason, and there's
yep.
There's, you know, if you're a true MLG pro gamer over here, okay, yep. You can find the hidden parts to it.
Yes.
Make it a little easier on yourself. If you, speaking of which, there's a little Mario thing, Mario ad right here. Interesting. Anyway.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Anyway, but yeah, so.
That later.
Oh, yeah, it's Super Mario RPG.
Yeah, okay, so you already know.
Oh, yeah. Well,
yeah, they remade it.
Yeah, and I forgot to include it.
That one doesn't count.
How does that not count?
That one's more like in line with Paper Mario and the Mario and Luigi RPGs on the Game Boy and DS.
Paper Mario is another thing entirely, but...
This plays a lot more like Paper Mario than what we're doing.
Oh, I know, but it's... should I include... Yes, I'm including it.
Fine.
We're including it, kind folks.
Alright.
And you're not seeing what I'm doing over here because... I carefully crafted it that way. But yeah, we're including it because it's... Is it technically? No, but... It... Yeah, you can make an argument for it because it's just that good. Anyway.
Yeah.
Anyway, sorry, continue. NES.
Super
Mario Bros. Just...
It's a classic for a reason, okay? Kind folks,
mm-hmm.
listen.
Mm-hmm.
Are there any bugs to it, though?
Yes.
Oh, are there?
Yes.
Is there more than Super Mario 64?
No.
Oh, okay, well.
I don't think so, no.
Yeah, there may be some bugs to it, but still, it's a certified banger, okay? And it's... It's basically... Yeah, it's basically the...
It's basically, there you go.
I don't even know what it is. It's the baseline...
It's hard to find words to describe it, for sure. It's just iconic.
It's the baseline video game. It's like the baseline video game. I mean, Sonic was basically Sega's version of Mario in almost every way. Yeah. It's just faster and more intense, I guess, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah, it's that good. It's that classic.
I mean, if you want a good game to speedrun, that's it. Is probably the most speed ran.
Putting it right there, kind folks. That S tier right there.
That's a great place for it. And you know what else is going to go
Super Mario 3? I mean, of course. Naturally. Tanuki Mario, anybody? Kind folks. Are you kidding me right now? Kind folks.
Kind folks.
Tanuki Mario?
Yep.
Are you kidding me right now? Come on. Kind folks.
Fully new Super Mario World.
Yeah, I mean, if only I knew that.
Cade Mario.
Oh, I know that. I know.
You can actually fly through the whole level sometimes.
I know that. And there's the
Sackbuster may go, huff, huff.
Yeah, he hears something. Looking all cute over there, anyway. Anyway, though. But yeah, Super Mario Bros. 3, a.k.a. He also had... Also, one of the first video game films of all time, aka The Wizard, basically Super Mario Bros. 3 commercial, everybody.
Yep. You know how they were able to get the footage? You know,
son?
Sackball. Anyway. this game came out, like, a good 2 years earlier in Japan than it did in the States.
Of course it did.
And I'm assuming that's how they were able to get footage for it. What year did The Wizard come out?
1989.
Ah, yep. And it came out in 88 in Japan. I have it complete in the box for both the Famicom.
I love the Power
and
Glove.
And I also have it complete in the box for the Nintendo Entertainment System.
I love the Power Glove. It's so bad. It's so bad. Anyway, enough about that. This game is basically Super Mario Bros. 2, as it should have been, okay? Listen. None of that lost level crap. None of that...
In some ways,
None of that cheating and basically reskinning another game into Super Mario Bros. Or whatever, okay?
Or just this is the making true. A hard version of the first one.
Yeah, this is the... AKA the lost level crap that I mentioned before. This...
There are other differences, but they're minor.
This is the true sequel
to
the Super Mario Bros. On the NES. Okay, listen.
In many ways, it is.
This is...
A true successor.
Oh, yes.
The word I would use there.
The true successor. Okay. Just like... as we'll see later on, Super Mario Galaxy is the true successor to Super Mario 64.
We'll be talking about that.
I guess we will.
Because one of these games has some catchy music that I never get out of my head.
Anyway, though, this is the true successor to the original classic. Okay, it built upon the first one in all the best ways. Truly amazing. Dare I say it? I'm putting it just below Odyssey.
Hey! No barking. Why did...
He's just ferocious. Here. Son? Where would you rate it? Otherwise, I'm putting it where I want to put it.
What, 3?
Yes.
Well, what's an S tier? I already said that.
I wanted to put it just underneath Super Mario Odyssey. What do you have to say about that?
It needs to be right next to Super Mario World. I don't care which end, it just has to be next to World.
Oh, I'm gonna put it below Super Mario 64.
My sack
right there.
Is almost busted.
Hey, I'm putting it right there. What do you have to say about that?
At least he didn't get the sack. The dog.
I'm kidding. I'm putting you right there.
Awakened. That is good.
Indeed. Anyway. New Super Mario Bros. Wii.
Good.
It's another good one. It's basically 3D Mario, but with a 2D skin. Yeah, now the Sackbuster's in his cave.
He's just chilling in the closet.
Yeah, that's his cave. He likes chilling in there.
Okay, that's kind of funny. Anyway,
yeah, this one is basically a 2D Mario with a 3D skin.
Yeah.
And for the Wii, and that's it. That's basically, yeah. It's nothing special.
I believe this is the direct successor to the one on the DS, like the original New Super Mario Bros.
Yeah, I remember this is where Super Mario got very confusing, where it was like
a little bit.
There's New Super Mario Bros. New quote unquote New Super Mario Bros. But then there's Super Mario Bros. Wii, new Super Mario Bros. 2 on the DS.
Yeah.
Then there's new Super Mario Bros. U. It's all over the place and it's confusing and I don't understand.
There's one on the Switch too, if I'm not mistaken.
It's I think they just combined.
Oh, is that what it is?
It's like a compilation, I think.
Oh, okay.
Something like that.
I haven't played that one.
I know they haven't released a new Super Mario Bros. For the Switch.
Oh, yeah,
New
Super Mario Brothers U Deluxe or something.
Yeah,
I think
yeah,
that's
that.
It
that's it, yeah. I didn't include it because it's basically...
It's like Mario Kart 8.
It's like Mario Kart 8. Instead of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, it's got everything, okay? I mean, these are separate games. We should include them as separate games and not just the end all be all, I guess.
I got you. This game is pretty cool. It came in a red case where every other Wii game is basically a white case.
Yeah, I remember that.
There's a red Wii also bundle.
It's just for me though, it's not anything necessarily that special though. It fills the Mario quota.
Yeah, maybe so.
Like if you don't have an NES, and you want 3D, there you go. It's a platformer. You know, it's a screen platformer, whatever.
They did add the little helicopter helmet power up.
I guess.
I think that was added in there. I liked it. It's a good game.
It's
fun.
Fine.
It's just
fine.
You're all right, though. It's not like the original one. They didn't really change a whole lot, except better graphics being on the Wii versus the DS.
Yeah. It's fine. Plus, it's old now.
It's old now. It is. You're right.
That's a stupid name.
It was new at the time, and that's what mattered at the time.
It was new at the time, but if it's going to be new Super Mario Bros. Wii forever and ever, amen, that's a stupid name, I'm sorry.
Yeah, in retrospect, it's kind of ironic.
Where would you rate it? I would put it
that
in C tier, honestly.
No, it's not that low.
I mean, it's fine. Like, Super Mario Bros. Run is fine.
This one's tough. I'd say I'll say it's an A, and then we put it in B tier. I think that's probably the best solution for that one.
Fine. Whatever.
I really liked it, but, you know, from an outside perspective, the B2 seems about right.
Yeah, I suppose. But Super Mario Galaxy, come
on.
On
the other hand, kind folks.
Come on, kind folks. Super Mario Galaxy, come on. Are you kidding me right now? Okay, listen. Was this supposed to be on the what was that?
GameCube?
Was it supposed to be on the GameCube? Yes. Okay. Did I care? No, because it's on the Wii and it's great. Okay, listen. Listen.
It was not a launch title or anything.
It wasn't, but it's...
Actually, I think it was a few years before it came out, from what I recall.
It took a long time for this game to come out. They originally were supposed to put it on the GameCube.
I did not know that.
Like, the test footage was like...
Oh.
Circles or whatever, and they were like, oh, what's a good thing to have circles with? Planets? Okay. That's where it got Super Mario Galaxy there. Ladies and gentlemen, we got them, okay? Super Mario Galaxy, beautiful. It is not my favorite, but it's very high. It's in the top three, okay? Listen, it is in the top three. This Super Mario Bros. Wii, I don't know why that's on the Wii. This, I understand why it's on the Wii, okay? You use it. You use that controller, okay?
You do.
Listen.
Yep. The motion control plays a factor to a degree.
It doesn't... If you don't have that, you know, nunchuck or that
Wii remote... Yeah, you need the nunchuck.
Yeah, if you don't have that nunchuck, you don't have that Wii remote, okay? You can't play it, okay? Listen. Get that pro controller, you can't play it, okay? Classic controller, you could, but it's not that fun, okay?
You may not even have to, okay?
There's a reason. There's a reason, okay? And it's good. It's a good story, okay? Listen.
That nunchuck tethered to the remote.
Yeah. Listen. It's that good, okay?
It's really good.
It is
no
really good.
No questions asked. Liked it a lot.
It is very, very good.
It had some difficult parts, though.
It had some difficult parts, just like it had with Super Mario Odyssey. But
this one, I recall having more difficult parts, though.
I gotta say, though, that's why it's not, you know, the top level S tier for me, okay?
I see.
But listen, okay? This...
It will never be below A.
No. Okay, listen. But, that being said, Super Mario Odyssey, that's going to be on top, okay? Always and forever again. But, is it going to be above or below Super Mario Bros. 3?
For me, below.
Below. Wow, okay. So below.
That's how good those original ones are.
Above or below Mario
those
War.
Are... Below.
Whoa.
I mean, if it's below 3, it's automatically below World.
Whoa.
Above
or below the first Mario Bros. Super Mario Bros.
Below.
Whoa.
Oh. It's a little different than what I was thinking.
Whoa.
That's the order we have may not be my order in the ranking, sub-ranking the S tier games, but...
Yeah.
I'm not going to nitpick it that hard.
Okay.
As long as they're all S tier, that's what counts, you know, for me.
I guess.
You know.
Since you have it in between here, I'll have it in between here. We're gonna divide it up a little bit here, okay?
If that game's an S tier, it would be...
Galaxy?
Yeah, if that's going in S for me, it would be, like, the lowest S.
Super Mario Galaxy is the lowest S for you? What in the ass is this?
I mean, it's a great game, but...
Were you thinking we were talking about Super Mario 3?
No. I was a... It's like, that one to me is... Personally, I think I even like the North American SMB2 more. That one is so fun. I don't care what you say. But
fine, I'll put it.
It it
I'll put it here.
It's either S or A.
I'll put it right here. How's that? Is that
a doable? I'm fine with that.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll give it an S tier. It's pretty iconic.
Fine. Even my ranking, as of this recording, personally, Odyssey, Galaxy, and 3. That's my ranking. It's my top 3 right there.
Okay.
But
all good choices.
But if it's above Mario 64, you know I love that game.
What?
I'd say this is, because here's the thing too.
CIB.
Here's the thing, okay? Nintendo themselves have even said that Super Mario Galaxy is the true successor to 64, okay? Nintendo says it.
Yeah.
Take it with a grain of salt, but still, you gotta take it anyway, you know?
Not that this next game is bad. This one might be controversial for us here, but I'm curious. Have you played this one?
I have not played this one, but what? I have heard of it.
What?
Yes, I don't have a Game Boy, or I don't have a GameCube. I don't have a GameCube.
You have to whisper GameCube, because that's what the woman used to say on the early 2000s commercials.
I've never played...
It was trendy and hip.
I never played the GameCube.
You never played the GameCube.
The only times I've played anything...
GC.
I don't know why. The GameCube is just in that realm right now that's like...
That's
not nostalgic... Yeah, it's not nostalgic enough where you can get a deal on it.
Beg to differ.
Well, I can't.
It's entered that zone.
Maybe it finally has entered in it. I haven't had the money to get one, okay? Listen. But anyway.
I think they're selling for like $100 or 80.
Well, I need to find one then. Fine. Anyway.
I found one at GameStop when I was 5.
Great for you. I'm not going to GameStop ever again. Anyway, Super Mario Sunshine.
At GameStop.
I've heard of this game.
Yep.
All I know is that it's Mario at a beach, and that's basically it. No. Son, what do you have to say on that?
There's more to it than that. The beach thing is a big part of it. More specifically, like the... You know how in 64 there's the castle's like the main hub area?
Mm-hmm.
Galaxy has that, whatever that central portal thing is.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember what that was called. That's on a Sunshine. It's the, like this coastal island place called Isle of Delphi.
AKA the beach. Oh, roasted.
It does have a town though.
Okay, well there you go.
Fine. Yeah, water is a big theme in this one though.
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay, here's the thing. Okay, yeah. Not to say that Sunshine's bad.
It's definitely not bad.
I've heard good things about it.
And you'll hear more from me.
Indeed. But all I'm saying is that Galaxy's done... I don't know. I've heard a lot more good things about Galaxy than I have with Sunshine. That's all I have to say.
I can see that. Yeah.
Why do you think we've heard more good things about Galaxy than Sunshine dive into it?
It's like you said, Galaxy really is more of a true successor.
Indeed.
In the way that the game is laid out, it plays a lot more like 64 than Sunshine does. Now, Sunshine definitely does retain a lot of elements. It's still a big 3D open world, collect all the item.
But what's different about this game? What is the Sunshine-ness, if you will?
Sunny island that you're on?
That's it?
Thing is, you're trying to collect these like suns.
Sell me on Sunshine over here.
So it has a very neat gameplay mechanic where you have this robot called Flood, which I forgot what the acronym stood for. Flood is a water jet robot thing where the whole game essentially, with a very few exceptions, you've got this robot on your back like a backpack. And you can use this robot to kind of hover over the ground. You can spray enemies. There's some other maneuvers. And you unlock maneuvers as you go through the game. And I believe each ability is like a nozzle attachment for the flood robot. That's what it is. And you just cycle through them. So that's a big part of it. There's a... if you're familiar with Metal Mario...
Metal? Oh yeah, I am.
Well...
Metal Mario. A.K.A. from...
SM64. That is a thing also.
It's from, I know him from Mario Kart, if you will.
Anyway. Okay. That's more what I'm referring to here. Super Mario 64, Metal Mario is like a power-up.
Oh.
But in this game, it's a separate character. There was like this evil Mario clone that's kind of like chrome-plated metal looking. That's Metal Mario, essentially. Somehow took this like paintbrush thing and just completely destroyed this island town. And also did a lot of... It's hard to explain, really.
Dun, 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 dun.
A lot of the levels also have these, like, goop piles, almost. I don't know how else to word it.
Alright. Well, anyway.
A lot of it's, you're cleaning up that as well.
Cleaning the beach, a.k.a. save the beaches.
It does have a little bit of that in it.
Anyway,
they tapped into that in the American commercial, which was not a good commercial. It was a little bit too,
preachy.
Yeah, it was a little bit more like, a little too kid friendly.
Anyway,
the Japanese commercial's better. Point being,
I do see the graphics, and
they are
a lot better.
They are good.
64.
They look on point for a GameCube game, for sure.
Quite.
You played Double Dash on the cart. It's
in,
like that.
In Sunshine? Oh, okay.
The graphics-wise, it's like that. Quite.
Anyway, though, where would you rank it, son?
I'd say it's at the very least an A.
At the very least an A. Where on the A spectrum?
Yeah, it's probably a good spot for it.
Where in the spectrum?
Definitely towards the upper end of the A.
How about right there? Is that a doable spot there? Or what?
Yeah, we can go with that.
Indeed. Anyway, though.
Catchy music in it, also.
Yeah, I heard it's got some good music in there. Anyway, though. New Super Mario Bros. On the DS. I played this, and it brought Mario to the DS.
No, it didn't.
Basically. No,
no,
it brought the 2D platforming Mario to the DS.
That it did.
There you go. That's why. Anyway.
Yes.
I suppose it's fine. Like I said.
Yeah. Good game.
Fairly so.
Giant Mario was a big thing.
Yeah. Hence the giant Mario in the promotional material.
Yes.
But anyway, yeah. I guess that's a big thing. That's a one of the things, I guess, but...
Yeah.
I don't know. It's just like, if... Why... go and do all these 3D, 2D platforming Mario games where you can just have the original one on the DS? I don't understand. I maybe to get the graphics up, but still, you know, you can just... You can... There's so many other things you can do than a 2D platforming Mario game now. There's 3D Mario worlds and all that
there
now.
There is, listen. But 2D Mario platforming games are just that good.
They're, I guess.
I know. It's the S tier.
I mean, yeah, that's why I got Super Mario Bros. And Super Mario Bros. 3.
And okay. Gold.
Yeah, I guess.
I know.
I don't. But anyway, those two games up there, I agree with you on the S tier, but...
I'm not saying this one's an S tier.
It's
not for me. It's...
For me, it's fine. It's the big Mario, that's fine, you know? It's just... Super Mario Bros. Again, this time 3D, this time on the DS, this time there's big Mario. That's
See,
it.
I get it. It makes more sense on a DS, though, because it's a handheld and it's easy to play something like that in the car. You know, for me.
That is true.
On the Wii, though, it's a little bit more like...
For kids' sake.
I haven't played it's that like one in a while,
kinda
but
like
I liked it.
Kind of like Pokemon, you know? You got that RPG-ness, I guess,
yeah.
Fine.
Put this one in A.
Probably. A?
On the lower end of A, but A.
I was thinking lower end of B.
Absolutely not.
I guess upper end of B.
Sure.
Fine.
It's going to be below the American 2.
The American 2?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I'm putting it right here.
No, I meant the... Yeah. Yep.
The end.
That works.
Anyway, Super Mario Bros. 2.
I have not played this one.
Super Mario Bros. 2.
Haven't played it.
I don't remember if this has got Big Mario in it. But
it probably does.
I played it. I can't remember if... I can't... Oh,
you played this one?
Yes, but okay. I can't remember if this one had Big Mario in it.
I have not played this one yet.
I hate the name. Because it's not new anymore.
I mean,
it's old.
I figured it was just kind of more of the same at this point.
It is more of the same.
That's why I'd never played it.
That's
personally.
Why. That's why I'm getting.
Yet.
This. Yeah, I mean, that's why I'm getting. This is getting old for. This. These games at this point in time were getting old for me because they were just the same thing. I was
it's
like,
something that I would like to
look Super Mario Bros.
Revisit.
And there's new Super Mario Bros. 2.
That was true.
And there's new Luigi. New Super Mario Bros. It's all this new crap, and I was like, don't thank you for this, but I don't care.
I mean, I feel like they should have named that series more in line with the other 2D ones, like Super Mario Brothers DS or something.
And the one's calling.
I believe so, but we'll call her back in a moment.
Indeed. Anyway, though, since I'm the one that played it and you didn't, I'm gonna put it.
It's going down.
Underneath Super Mario Run. Because...
Yes.
Simply because... For me, at least, the new Super Mario Bros. Line, I'm sick and tired of it.
Yeah.
I just want more. I want more than just... the same, you know? And it feels like it's the same thing. Anyway, though, you know it's not the same. Our last one that was a clever additive, if you will. Super Mario RPG.
Yes.
Now, I played this. It's clearly the best thing it's one of the best things that the SNES has ever brought us.
Graphically, it was very, very ambitious on that console.
There was a chip
yep.
put within the cartridge?
Yep, just like a Star Fox.
Yeah, for the thing. And I was like, whoa! You know? Whoa! Oh. 3D Mario on the SNES, whoa! Anyway.
Wowee! I used to know.
This was very, very fun. Is it, you know, the best Mario game of all time? No. Okay.
No.
I'm not an RPG person.
And I am definitely not, but...
I'm not necessarily an RPG person, like a Pokemon person, which is very, truly an RPG game. But, yeah. I will say that Super Mario Bros. RPG... or Super Mario RPG is the one of the best RPGs I've ever played.
Yeah. For sure.
Have you played it?
Yes, I do own a copy of it.
Quite. So what did you think of it?
I thought it was a good game. It honestly is very in line with Paper Mario.
It is.
I mean, it's very similar to Paper Mario.
Paper Mario is its own thing. It's not. It's yeah.
Sort of, yeah.
This is a late introduction because simply, we gotta talk about it.
It's like kind of a precursor to the Paper Mario series. That's always how I viewed it.
Yeah.
So, as a matter of fact, in Japan, I think it's called Mario's Story and then Paper Mario's. Maybe not. I think no. No, Paper Mario is just Mario's Story in Japan. Okay. Yeah.
Overall, yeah, I say it's fine. It's a good game. It's not, you know, the best thing. Certainly not the worst thing, let me tell you. Okay.
No.
But it's definitely not the best thing. Where would you rank it?
A lot of this is because of the really iconic nature of it. I'm going to put it in A tier.
Oh, wow. That's higher than I thought it was going to be. Me too. Yeah, I'll put it in A tier as well. Lower A tier, though.
Yep.
Right there.
I would not say it's better than Super Mario Bros. 2. But, yeah.
I would.
I know you would. Hey, no. Yeah. Again, I just care that they...
Right there. Right
that's
there.
Better. As long as they're on the tier.
Fine. Anyway, that's it. That's the list. Can't believe that we did it. Can't believe we did it, but yeah. Here it is. We did it.
Here we go.
As per usual, I knew with this kid, we could have gotten so many S tiers, A tiers.
There just aren't. Good one. Square.
Thank you. Anyway.
Yep. The majority of the Mario games are good. There's very few that are bad, and even then, they're... If we're talking official Nintendo ones...
Very few.
They're, like, not one as bad as it could be.
One in a blue moon. I would personally say the new Super Mario Bros. Games are just... autopilot, basically, but...
Sort of. They don't suck, though.
They're not bad games. They're just autopilot games, in my eyes. But anyway,
in a sense.
But yeah, that's all I gotta say about it. Mario's great. The movie's actually good. Illumination animation.
It's their magnum opus.
It is their magnum opus, yes.
I said
it's actually,
it in the parking lot.
It's actually a good film. It's a miracle.
Yeah.
That movie exists. They're gonna make a 2, of course. It's probably gonna suck.
We'll see.
But then again, we all thought this one was gonna suck, but it actually rocked. Sort of. So, whatever.
Yeah.
Anyway, though, guys. What do you think? What's your Mario list? Is Super Mario World this high? Or is Super Mario Maker this low? What do you guys have to say about it? Where did you put Super Mario Bros. Wonder? Comment and let us know, and don't forget to subscribe, ring that bell. More vids coming your way. Son, what you gotta say?
Little honorary mention to Hotel Mario, as promised at the beginning. The game itself is kind of crappy, but it's not an official Mario game from Nintendo in its entirety.
Baby, and, I want to touch your
collar. Yeah, the cutscenes alone make it worth playing, because they almost offset the bad gameplay, because the cutscenes are just that hilariously bad.
Indeed.
Oh my god.
And after that...
Yep.
I'm Slam, this is Skits. We'll talk to you in the flippity-flop, kind folks.
Dub to you later.